How's it going, Internet? I'm Nick Limone, filling in for Sydney Goodman, who I promise is not on vacation, just working from San Francisco today. So you're stuck with me while we dive into a potential new Switch model to be taken with one giant grain of salt, a Pokemon Direct, and the PS5 logo reveal. Let's do this. New reports are going around yet again that a more powerful Nintendo Switch Pro model is coming sometime this year. This rumor has been floating around since probably just about this time last year. So again, keep all of the following in mind with a giant grain of salt. According to sources from a supply chain company, DigiTimes reports that the new Switch model enters production of Q1 this year for release sometime in the middle of 2020. Now, this isn't a completely crazy thing for Nintendo to do. They're known for iterating on their handheld hardware. Just take a look at the Nintendo DS, DSi, DSi XL, 3DS, 3DS XL, 2DS, 2DS, you get it, there's a lot of them. But in an interview with GamesIndustry.biz, Dr. Serkan Toto of Canton Games says, quote, "There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that Nintendo will launch a Switch Pro in 2020. More specifically, I predict 4K support, bigger cartridge sizes, and of course, beefed up components." RAM. Chef with like ground beef. Ugh, gross. Other analysts like Piers Harding Rolls of IHS Market Technology says, quote, "The likelihood of a higher end Switch in 2020 has significantly diminished since the launch of an improved flagship Switch and Switch Lite." So as you can see, no one really knows what's going on. But we're talking about it because everyone's talking about it. So now you can sort of understand how all up in the air this is. I'd personally love a Switch Pro. I'm one of the weirdos who traded in his launch Switch for a slightly improved Switch V2 because GameStop had a very good deal for upgrading. So I'd probably do it again for a Pro model. But would you? Please let us know in the comments. I'm curious if people would triple or even quadruple dip on the Switch. So let me know. Pokemon fans scorned and hopeful alike, gather around. Nintendo announced today via Twitter that a Pokemon Direct is coming this Thursday, January 9th at 6:30 a.m. PST, which is early for most West Coasters here in the States. But I'm usually up at around that time to avoid traffic so I can get to work early. It's a whole thing. The Direct is planned for around 20 minutes runtime and will likely include an update on Sword and Shield, hopefully with the addition of some non-Galar Pokemon. Release dates for Pokemon Home and Pokemon Sleep are likely, and I know some people over on the Pokemon subreddit are hopeful for another Mystery Dungeon game, like your boy right here. Seriously, the last great Mystery Dungeon was Shirin the Wanderer, the Tower of Fortune, and the Dice of Fate. So good. So good. Go play it, it's on Vita. And of course, a Pokemon Snap sequel, God willing. But who cares about little old me? What do you want from Pokemon? Let us know in the comments. Is there anything that'll make you happy? The Consumer Electronics Show is going down right now over in Las Vegas, and in addition to 8K TVs and wild electric car helicopter hybrids, we got a pretty decently sized gaming reveal. PlayStation President and CEO Jim Ryan, man, what a cool title, President of PlayStation. Anyway, he took to the Sony stage and revealed the logo for the PlayStation 5, and it looks an awful lot like the PS2, PS3, and PS4 logos, which is fine. But this is news because I guess logo designs make this all official, which is still pretty exciting. You surprised? Probably not, but if you are, let us know in the comments. And that was your Daily Fix for January 7th. I'm Nick Limone, and I hope you had a lovely day. And now that you're all caught up on the news, check out all of IGN's follow-up Mandalorian coverage, because my boy Jesse off-cam over here, he has worked so hard on it.
This is the way.
This is the way. Subscribe to the Daily Fix on Snapchat, and for all things, everything else, IGN.com.